So in Ohio, the School Choice Ohio group has decided to have its own, there's lawsuits everywhere these days in this world, Chris.
Yeah, they are suing two school districts on the grounds that they are deliberately not providing contact information for kids because the districts don't want those kids to go to charters.
Wait, explain that again to me. Not
providing information, contact information for children. Because the districts fear, this is what School Choice Ohio is alleging, the districts fear that those kids, or many of those kids, will want to go to charters. I spoke to the lawyer who's representing School Choice Ohio, and he talked to me briefly.
What these schools are doing in general is saying that they've adopted policies regarding what's known as directory information under the Family Education Rights and Privacy Act, which allows some discretion to schools as to the information that they will disclose regarding the students who attend their districts. Now, Cincinnati came back last fall and said that they were not allowing disclosure of any information of the type, the name, the addresses that School Choice Ohio would need. And so we sent a follow request in February asking for the basis for this policy and their compliance with this policy. And they've completely ignored that request, really leaving no choice but to bring this matter to the court.
So School Choice Ohio is saying that the districts are giving out this information to all kinds of other groups, like businesses, colleges, employers. They just don't want the school choice group to have the information about the kids.
Right.
That they might be contacted. I don't know. So Sam, your take on something like this, I guess this isn't so much of a public policy discussion of school choice as a what is the meaning of privacy in 2014 in the state of Ohio?
Well, and I think it is going to be a significant case based on how it's ruled. I think, just common sense tells you that for the traditional public school, if they feel this other sector is coming to take them down, they're obviously not going to willingly turn over information that makes it easier for their chief opponents to contact kids and families. So, that makes sense to me. And what is interesting is seeing how the court goes, and to the extent that this information just becomes more or less publicly available going forward.
Yeah, I guess the charter schools probably, are they required to give information to the district schools regarding their kids? So, certainly it would be hard to, if in fact the regular districts do give this information out, they are publicly run, unlike the charters. If they give information out to all these employers and all these other groups, does a publicly run institution, are they able to pick and choose? We like you, so we're publicly run, we're government-run entity, and we like you, we'll give it to you. We don't really like you so much, we're not going to give it to you. Is there any other precedent for a government-run institution to pick and choose the people to whom it offers information?
Well, it's definitely a bad precedent that they've established, if that's true, that they've already given this information out freely to other entities.
Yeah.
That's going to make it a much more difficult case to win, I would think.
Mm-hmm.